We've always prided ourselves in trying to be innovative. Nationwide, people have recognized us as being some of the leaders in certain areas of the field, including living donor liver transplantation, developing a transplant institute, the whole robotic kidney transplant part of it. We are definitely one of the innovators, and people look to us for guidance. Any person who gets a kidney transplant, even if you're the skinniest person or the heaviest person, your minimum incision size is at least 1 foot long. And with a robotic kidney transplant, we just need enough of a hole in order to put the kidney in, which is about 2 inches in size. So the largest incision during a robotic kidney transplant is 2 inches, which obviously, if you think about it, will have generally less pain and less complications from the wounds that we have. With the Da Vinci robot, we're able to go ahead and use technology to increase our definition visually, as well as getting better binocular vision. You're looking at a three-dimensional picture through a series of dual lenses, and you're able to get as close as you want to the area of focus. So no longer is a 3-millimeter needle 3 millimeters. It looks almost about 3 inches long, so it's really easy to work with. And also with the robot and the technology we have with that, we can definitely change the fine nature of our movements. So our movements are much finer robotically than they are in real life.
Presently, we've limited the robot kidney transplant operation to the living donor kidneys transplants that we do. However, at some point I could foresee us doing them with deceased donor kidney transplants, and where we'll have a larger number of patients and experience. As surgery moves forward, there's more and more movement towards minimally invasive surgery. As technology improves, I think that it could only help the kidney transplant operation also.
Well, the pain was just unbelievably minimal. Within a week, I really didn't have any pain. I have maybe a 2-inch incision on my navel and a couple pokes in my stomach. That's the only scarring. I don't have nothing to compare it to, you know, like how you feel after a regular surgery of a kidney transplant. So I don't know if you feel this good or if it, you know, you heal so quickly, but I kind of attributed that to the robot.
We have done over 100 at this moment. We are doing it consistently for more than half our living donor cases, mostly because we're trying to make sure we train our trainees both techniques in general. We only do about 50 living donor kidney transplants a year, so more than half of them are done robotically. But the people are demonstrating that they feel more comfortable in a short-term perspective. We don't have the complications. We don't have the long length of stays associated with the incision and incision-related problems. Right now, the operation is very standardized, and we don't think twice about doing it for any patient at all.
Pretty much everything that we do in life, if we don't innovate, I think that things become stagnant, and then we don't really learn, and we don't get better. We're trying to do what's best for the patient, and I think that's what really drives us.